Okay, Christine.
Oh no, me?
That's what he said.
Hi, don't know where to start.
Tell him how you got stuck.
Out.
It's a mess.
It's a mess.
day I went to our doctor down the block. Sure enough, acute appendicitis. They rushed me right to the hospital. Well, I figured this floor would cover everything the rest of my life. And when I was 13, I had my first wet dream. Well, I went right back to the book. Milky discharge, milky discharge, milky discharge. Gonorrhea, I was in shock, I mean gonorrhea. Before I even started, I couldn't tell my mother that I had gonorrhea. So the book said to drink a lot of water.
Is that what was it?
No, it said to take penicillin, strepto, pepto, bismol, something or other. But I couldn't do that unless I told somebody. So all I could do was drink the water, and I drank like 20 glasses a day. For 3 weeks, hell, I nearly drowned. Finally, I decided that I would go to confession, and I would tell my priest that I had gonorrhea. He was in shock, too.
Thank you.
I turned 15, I lied about my age so I could join ACT, you know.
The nightclub union, cause I could make $60 a week working at strip joints outside Jersey City. I worked this one club for about 8 weeks straight, and I really became friendly with the stripper. Her name? Lola Latour. And her dynamic twin 44s. Well, Lola really took kindly to me. I mean, we did share the only dressing room, and let me tell you, she did a lot of dressing.
Anyway, she used to come and pick me up and drive me to work at night. Well, the niggas would all be hanging outside their windows, and she drive up in her big pink Cadillac convertible and smile.
And I would just come stripping out of the house with my little tuxedo attached to me and Lola would take off down the lines with her red hair blowing in the wind.
Walking down the hall, you'd have to walk like this with all your.
and the bus. The bus is the worst. I just look at a bus and bingo! And then there was the time I was making out in the backseat with Sally Ketchum. We were naked, and I was feeling her boobs. And feeling her boobs. And after about an hour or so, she says, don't you want to feel anything else? And I suddenly thought to myself, no, I don't.
Did anyone surprise you?
Yeah, I guess. I think that was the first time I realized I was a homosexual. And I got really depressed because I thought that being gay meant being an outcast the rest of my life. A bum. And I remember saying, gee, I'll never get to wear nice clothes. And I was really into both of them. I just found this pair of hard clothes coming out fast.
Oh,
New York, New York, here I come! Except I had one minor problem, see. I was ugly as sin. I was ugly, skinny, homely, unattractive, and flat as a pancake. Get the picture? Anyway, I got off the bus in my little white shoes, my little white tights, my little white dress, my little ugly face, and my long blonde hair, which was natural then. I look like a fucking nurse. I had $87 in my pocket and 7 years of tap acrobatics. I could do 180-degree split from a tap box ago.
Oh! When did you start dancing, Paul?
Not till very late.
Why?
I don't know why. I just did.
Well, what did you do?
Well, nothing much.
Come on, Paul. You must have done something. How old were you when you did start dancing?
16.
Well, what did you hope for the time you were 16? I mean, what was your family like?
We were close.
Close? Brothers? Sisters?
Two sisters. One died when I was 14.
How?
Say, Zach, can the kids sit down?
And smoke? Can the adults smoke?
All right. Everybody take a break. Out in the hall. Paul, we'll try this again later. Dancing.